So a question that comes up regularly is, how do I get started in data science? How, you know, what are the first steps to learning the basics of the field? What are some of the best resources to go to? And for those who've been in the field for a little while, you know, what are some of the resources that can be used to stay up to date? So that's, you know, what we want to talk about in this particular session. And so to, you know, if you're just getting started, two excellent online courses that you may want to explore are Learning from Data over with Caltech and Machine Learning from Stanford. So Yasser Abu Mustafa at Caltech puts together a great course that really touches both on the basics of machine learning and data science, and also throws in a little bit of learning theory. So, you know, has a pretty strong computer science approach there. And Andrew Ng's course touches on, goes into a number of additional classification methods and techniques, but also presents quite an array of starting techniques that you can use in to get into the field. So both, I recommend both of these quite highly. Also there are a number of books available that are some of which are even free. I've noted that with the red dots here. And if you look through some of these, certainly an Introduction to Statistical Learning and Learning from Data are two great texts. If you're going to start in one place, I would recommend an Introduction to Statistical Learning. That'll build up the foundations for both regression and classification, talk through some of the basics of evaluating performance of machine learning texts, of machine learning methods. And so a great starting point. As you start to go a little bit further, you know, there are a number of more advanced texts, The Elements of Statistical Learning, Pattern Recognition and Machine Learning and Deep Learning, that will build on those basics and either go into, you know, more sophisticated techniques, you know, everything from hidden Markov models to you know, deep neural networks. Those will be touched on in each of those texts, along with the math that goes along with it too. And there are a number of excellent applied texts, Hands-on Machine Learning with Scikit-learn and TensorFlow, and Deep Learning with Python. These both are a little bit more of a Python twist to them, which happens to be the tool that I use the most. But there are corresponding books for users of R out there that could be looked in as well. But depending on what you're looking for, you know, the introductory texts that are listed here, good starting points, and either going to the advanced text or the applied text, depending on what you're interested in. And I also put up a link on this page to a website that I constructed a couple of years back that lists a number of other freely available data science resources and links to free online texts, videos, online courses, all of these types of resources that may be valuable. So feel free to use that if it's helpful for your learning journey in this area. Additionally, you know, staying up to date, following a few either blogs or newsletters can be helpful here. You know, a number that either I subscribe to or that I know others who subscribe to include Data Elixir, Data Machina, the Data Science Roundup, and the Kaggle newsletter. For those of you not familiar with Kaggle, Kaggle is an online machine learning platform. This is a good website to go to. You can certainly compete in online machine learning competitions, which is actually a good way to start, becoming more active in this field, working on some real world problems. And I mean, a lot of them have monetary prizes if you're able to win them. Of course, it's a very, very high bar these days for winning them, but they also have some learning competitions there that are useful. And so, you know, would certainly recommend signing up for some of these, you know, because also we all want a little bit more email in our inbox, don't we? But no, but these are really, really useful resources all. And then, you know, to kind of stay the most up to date, we need to follow what the latest research is. So, you know, one way of doing that is to look at industry blogs. You know, these are kind of the bell labs of, you know, the 21st century here. Google Research, Microsoft Research, DeepMind, which is now owned by Google, but has you know, a blog there of their own as well, and Kaggle, as I mentioned before. You know, a number of these, you know, research groups, you know, are really producing cutting edge stuff and, you know, supervised, unsupervised, and reinforcement learning, and are well worth following. And, you know, there are a number of academic conferences that may be of interest too, to either attend or to, you know, check out the proceedings of, to see what some of the latest work is coming from the both the industry research labs, but also academic institutions in different universities and national labs around the country. So the International Conference on Machine Learning, ICML, you know, a lot of cutting edge stuff comes out at their annual conference, including as well as at NIPS, the Neural Information Processing Systems Conference. And so, you know, you're going to see, these are very hard conferences to get papers accepted into. And so a lot of the work that goes into them is truly cutting edge. The International Conference on Learning Representations, another good option there as well. Always good to browse the proceedings there. And the ACM SIGKDD Conference on Knowledge Discovery and Data Mining. There's also an applied track there, which is interesting to check out. Not that the others don't have applied papers, but SIGKDD, this Conference on Knowledge Discovery and Data Mining, has a specific applied track that may be of interest to those with you know, less of an academic interest in these types of technologies. The other thing to follow, if you really want to dive deeply into the waters, is archive. So this is a preprint, pre-publication online repository for journal articles, conference papers, which haven't necessarily been accepted yet or are working papers. These have not gone through the peer review process, but often are, you know, hot off the presses from various research institutions, so can be useful to check out. Now, archive itself is a bit of a rabbit hole with, you know, many, many papers being uploaded each and every day. So Andre Carpathy had created a tool for filtering these and helping to make it a little bit easier to go through some of the most viewed and cited papers, which is using the Archive Sanity Preserver tool, which is what's being shown here, which just helps you kind of, you can look at the most recent or some of the most popular recent articles that have appeared. And so it can be useful for kind of filtering through the noise of that many papers. But yeah, if you really want to deep dive into the latest and greatest, the Archive and Archive Sanity Preserver are the way to go there. You know, additionally, you know, there's often no better source than going straight to the researcher's mouth, right? So following, you know, this is a number of folks who are leaders in data science, machine learning, deep learning, all of them, you know, really pushing the bounds here. And so, you know, with this, you know, I would highly recommend, you know, following these folks on your favorite social media platform, you know, checking out their respective organizations and research groups. You have an assortment here of some of the all-stars in the field. You know, Jeffrey Hinton, Jan LeCun, Fei-Fei Li, pushing forward on deep learning and computer vision, along with Andre Carpathy, Andrew Ng, and Yashua Bengio, all really doing, you know, cutting edge work in that space. And then, you know, certainly, you know, for, you know, looking at deep reinforcement learning, David Silver over at DeepMind. And if you are so interested in exploring generative adversarial networks, GANs, which is a an up-and-coming topic. Certainly Ian Goodfellow has done a lot of work in that space as well. All of these folks really have been working on building the foundations in the space of some of the modern machine learning research, and can't recommend highly enough following their latest work.
How many R users do we have here? Okay, Python? Okay, MATLAB? An even distribution, that is indeed rare in a group. So, these each have their pros and cons. Probably depending on your field-specific needs and where different packages are for the work that you're doing, either of these could be a good option. The nice thing about R and Python is they're free. The nice thing about MATLAB is all the packages just work together. So there's a lot of pros and cons to each of these languages. So Python certainly has seen significant increases in uptake in the machine learning community, and is probably the most prominent of the three these days in that space. But certainly throughout different disciplines, all of them have a significant representation. And you can kind of see this is a regularly updated programming language index, and the level of the rating shows the relative popularity as according to their methodology, with Python, R, and MATLAB all being it's a very long list, so all being pretty high up there. So another thing that if you're going to be playing around with data science to any extent, you probably want some degree of version control. This is something you'll probably end up getting at some point. Managing changes to code over time, enabling collaboration, making that easier, and providing a complete history of changes made. You don't want to have, my file .v1, .v2, .v3. This takes care of all that for you. The two resources out there on that are very popular are Git, which is the system that does it, and then GitHub is certainly a very popular web-based hosting platform for Git repositories. There's also GitLab, which I believe Duke has a site license for as well. So those are some other options. Another tool that may be of interest here is the Jupyter Notebook. So this nicely combines code, which you can actually run within this notebook, with math and text into one easily shareable document. So great for making websites, for sharing a fully described set of processes with a collaborator. That's certainly an option to help with that. And the next evolution of Jupyter Notebook is Jupyter Lab, which allows you to have Jupyter Notebooks as well as a full what's known as integrated development environment. What does that mean? Well, we have the option to have a text editor as well as some other files open, seeing what some of the outputs may be. It has it all in one rather than having 12 programs open at once. So this could be another useful tool for you as well. And then data visualization, again, in terms of communicating it, if we have a scale on time to learn and ability to customize, those usually go together. We have Tableau, makes some beautiful charts. You can quickly load in data and make the charts if you want a little more flexibility. ggplot2 for R, matplotlib for Python, and then if you are a hardcore visualizer, you can go the full D3, data-driven documents, JavaScript implementation, make incredible New York Times-worthy interactive visualizations, okay? So, wrap up there. Any questions?